Roadrunner Rundown on Bakersfield.com and the CSUB Roadrunners Digital Network. Downtown Bakersfield, California.
Driving Harrington for the win! Yes! CSUB Roadrunners are your Western Athletic Conference baseball champions!
Here's the voice of the runners, Corey Costello.
And a good day to you. Welcome once again to Roadrunner Rundown, the official program, CSUB Roadrunner Athletics. My name's Corey Costello. Thanks so much for joining us once again on the show. We have an absolute jam-packed broadcast for you today. Thanks so much for joining us again here in Bakersfield, California. Downtown Bakersfield, California, to be exact. And we appreciate you joining us on the program. The show today is literally, it's jammed up with really some of my favorite people in the world, as a matter of fact. I don't play favorites, but no, I really like these people coming on the show today. We've got Dajy Vines from CESUB Women's Basketball, along with her teammate Alyssa Shannon, both seniors on the program, and we're going to be speaking with them coming up in the next segment. And then we're going to talk some soccer with Jamie Carey-Morrell. He will join us on the program as well, a sophomore with the Roadrunners. He had an assist in Bakersfield's victory over Grand Canyon, and we'll talk with him about the Roadrunners starting to find their traction a little bit in conference play. They split the weekend. Well, not really split. They got 4 points. They had a win and a draw this past weekend at home, so the Runners on the road for what's a pretty brutal stretch. They'll start on Friday at Seattle, and they'll be back at home on Sunday hosting first place in nationally ranked Utah Valley. So should be a very good weekend for Roadrunner men's soccer. We'll speak with Jamie Carey-Morrell about that. And our director of golf, Meghan Thomason, will join us in the final segment of the program. The golf program, who continues to fundraise to keep their program rolling and help keep golf in Bakersfield, is got a fundraiser coming up, a private dinner opportunity for those of you who are interested in helping out the golf program. So we'll speak with Meghan Thomason about that. Also, they've had a couple of their fall matches and tournaments, and we'll speak with her about the recap so far with some of those. So we got that happening on the program today. A lot of stuff to get to. Literally, I think I set a new record this week. This is a just to kind of pull down the the curtain here on the program. This is all the script for our upcoming highlights segment, because that much happened this past weekend at home. So you know what that means. I better shut up and get to it. Let's roll the highlights. We'll start with CSUB men's soccer. Two matches this past weekend. We'll start on Friday hosting Grand Canyon Friday night. Look at that crowd. Just shy of 1,700 packed in to watch this one. Late minutes of the first half, the long send to Hugo Vinales, who strikes with the left foot, and he gets his first goal in 2 years. Look at that celebration. Hugo is absolutely pumped. Makes a beeline for the bench. Let me give a hug to my coach and the rest of the team. Look at that celebration as the Roadrunners go up 1-0 at the half over Grand Canyon. Second half, 4 minutes in, and the Lopes will attack. Here's a great ball coming up here from Alberto Garcia, as he will find on the cross Damian Germán coming in with the side of the foot. He will bury it and tie the matchup at one apiece. Another look, great cross and finish for Grand Canyon. 3 minutes later, though, the Roadrunners, well, they would set it up on the corner kick. They play it short, and why? Because they're trying to find Jamie Carey-Morrell, because he can do that. The header to Mario Iniguez, and the Roadrunners win it on Friday night, 2-1 over Grand Canyon. So we'll head to Sunday's matchup. The rematch here is going to be Bakersfield and UNLV. This is a rematch from last year's WAC championship game. And 13th minute, Dante Nino, the cross to Julian Zamora with the header, his fifth goal of the season. CSUB up 1-0. And yes, Julian, when you score, you got to thank everybody. Thank you. Thank you. And don't forget the little people who gave you the cross. Dante Nino with the thank as well. Runners up 1-0 at the half. 65th minute. Here's, you know, look at that, by the way. Nice header from Zamora. Usually finishes with the feet, but he finishes with the head this time. And then here in the 65th minute, Rebels, we're on the move. They're going to get the breakaway. They were looking for it all game. They finally found it to Danny Masoski, leading scorer for the Rebels. He picks it away here, and he will finish with his 11th tally of the season, beating the goalkeeper there, and we are tied at one apiece. Referee in this one, he really liked, as you see Masoski celebrating with the rest of the Rebels after the goal. Referee really liked himself in this one. He's going to throw a threat. Look at that. I got your yellow cards right here in the pocket. And this match with the warning there. Winding down in regulation, UNLV a couple chances, but Oscar Glovius with one of his seven saves in the match. Look at this one again. This is off a redirect. Glovius with the dive, making the game-saving save one more time for CSUB. That is not easy to do. And we will force overtime. Into the first overtime, runners pushing the pace. One attempt to Duarte, not going to connect. Then the runners, though, will maintain possession and find Simon Doherty. The nice cross in front right here, but, yeah, just off. Good save, though, once again by Richard Garness. And here's a yellow card to Masoski. We had a lot of those late part of the match especially. Here come the yellows. Speaking of naughty, that's not okay, but apparently this is. You be the judge or the ref. Second overtime, UNLV on the corner kick, as there was a lot of these in the second OT for the Rebels. This one is going to go across, but just barely miss. And contact in the box again, no call, but contact here and a call. And, you know, this is what happens, boys and girls, when you don't control the match from an officiating standpoint. Things can sometimes get out of control. As the good news is a couple, how you doing? How you doing? How you doing? How you doing? And good news is the cooler heads prevailed in this one we got on to. Meanwhile, nobody's paying attention to the guy agonizing in pain. A few minutes later, Richie Grant, during a non-call on an offsides with the linesman, he summons the official, and Richie Grant is going to pick up a yellow card. Then as Grant walks away, as he walks away from the lead official, and on his way back to the bench, the lead official decides, you know what, you need one more. So the red card going to be issued to Richie Grant. So he was sent out of the game. By the way, his first red card of his 22-year coaching career. Final seconds, UNLV corner kick to no avail. We play 2-OT, and we come out with a 1-1 draw. So big, as expected in the matchup, the rematch of the two teams from last year's WAC championships, the Roadrunners and UNLV with a 1-1 tie, and Julian Zamora scoring his fifth goal of the season. That came on the heels of the victory on Friday night. Hugo Vinales, first goal in two seasons. Mario Niguez added his second goal in as many seasons. Runners pick up 4 points on the weekend. So speaking of points and standings, here's how it shakes out in the Western Athletic Conference. Seattle 3-1. Utah Valley 3-1. They're tied up top. UNLV, San Jose State, Grand Canyon, all there at 2-1, 2-1, 2-2. Houston Baptist 2-2. CSUB at 1-1. Air Force, UMKC, Incarnate Word, and UTRGV rounding out the rest of the team. So here's what's happening for the Roadrunners. They're going to have that brutal stretch this weekend. It starts with a weird split. They'll play Friday at Seattle, 7:30 p.m. Then they'll come back and play Sunday at 1 o'clock here at the main soccer field. That's going to be live on the WAC Digital Network. So a weird kind of split weekend where you play and then you're home instead of being on the road the entire weekend or home the entire weekend. So that's what we have coming up for men's soccer. Don't forget this weekend at the main soccer field. All right, on to CSUB women's soccer. They came off a double overtime loss on Friday night to UMKC 2-1, hosting Chicago State on Sunday, and things got a hand early. Amina settles. This is what you call a hat trick, but watch closely. She scores the first three goals of the match. So that was number one. Same play. We're not replaying the same play. This is like the same play, but different timing. There's goal number two. No, she beat Chicago State three times on the same exact run. As Settles finishes again, runners up 3-0 early, and that was just the beginning. 29th minute, it's going to be Taylor Wheeler off the 15-yard shot, and Wheeler finds the corner of the net. 4-0 CSUB. Then it really gets interesting. Haley Vincent of the Chicago State turnover finds the net, but she too was just getting started as Vincent then scores again. This is just 2 minutes later, ladies and gentlemen. Vincent has it sent out wide. She picks the pass, sends it to Kelly Mitchell, who feeds Vincent for the goal. Runners up 6-0 at the half. It's like Oprah. You get a goal, you get a goal. Haley Vincent gets another goal. This off a second half free kick following one Chicago State tally. 7-1 CSUB. Vincent has the hat trick. How about the sombrero? This one, prettiest of them all, by the way. Fancy footwork. Flip over the top. 8-1 CSUB. Everyone gets a goal. Maddie Giamana will get a goal here as well for the Roadrunners. This one off the nice pass. She takes her time and finishes. Roadrunners win it big over Chicago State on Sunday, 9-1. So the Roadrunners winning that one fairly handily. Amina settles three goals. Haley Vincent had four goals. And when you do that, you tend to win WAC offensive Player of the Week honors. So Haley Vincent with the victory there, and that came off the Kansas City 3-2 double overtime victory on Friday night. So a pretty good weekend for women's soccer. They got some points. Probably would have loved to have that Kansas City game as well, but still not in a bad spot for CSUB women's soccer, as they find themselves right now still near the top there in the conference. Seattle 4-1, Seattle 3-0-2. Utah Valley, I should say. Then Seattle, CSUB, 3-1-1 on the year. So right there in the hunt as they're going to be hosting the conference tournament in Bakersfield. Coming up for the Roadrunners, a tough test this weekend. They're going to see these two teams, the top two teams in the conference, twice in the next 2 weeks. So they're going to go to Seattle and Utah Valley this weekend. Then next weekend, they'll host Seattle and Utah Valley. Don't ask me how. That's what the WAC made the schedule like. So the Runners will see the top two teams in the next four matches. Should be a tough test for CSUB, as they'll be on the road this weekend, then home next week. All right, to volleyball. Roadrunners very busy this past weekend at home. Their home opener, Icardo Center against UT Rio Grande Valley. Close first set, tied at 5. Kelsey Sawyer with the block. Runners take the lead. Tied at 7 apiece, says here's Carol Grasso hitting off the block. And the Roadrunners start to take control. Bright spot of the evening for the Vaqueros, Bojana Mitrovic. She's had one of her team-high 14 kills for UTRGV. Sawyer not to be outdone. She's going to connect on the set from Martins. Sawyer had a match-high 15 kills. CSUB pulls away in set one. Great rallies for CSUB defense the entire match. Check out this scramble coming up as well. The Runners get it back. They'll finally set it to Sawyer. She records the kill, and the Roadrunners get the point. Not the first time, but the second time. Runners get the point. First glance at the home crowd for Aditza Urias, a Bakersfield product and transfer. She transfers that point, and CSUB ready to close out set one. It's Sawyer then with back-to-back finishes as the Roadrunners are going to win first set 25-19. Second set action, it's the Urias show. The kill and then the net cam with the block as well, and then she's going to hit off the block for another point. CSUB in control. Sawyer getting it done as well. Another kill for the Runners. They win set 2, 25-17. Third set, Sydney Haynes arriving with force for the kill. She had 13 in the match. One there, another one coming up after the rally as a Grasso shot gets blocked, and then Sydney Haynes, I got it, drops it down for the point. And how about some blocks? Usually just setting, but it's Louisa Martins with the block, and nobody celebrates like the Brazilians celebrate. Martins pumped as the Runners start the sweep. More from Martins is pretty set to Haynes, and the kill. Runners complete the sweep 3-0 over UTRGV. On to Saturday, first place, New Mexico State in town, hitting errors galore for both teams in the first set. It was a close one. New Mexico State, that was so many weapons, 5 players over 10 kills in this match. One from Bradley Nash. She had 14 as the Aggies. So much size at the net as well. Caused some hitting issues as Sasha Lee Thomas with the block for the Aggies. Tied at 23 at this point for the Roadrunners, as this was a problem all day. No answer in the middle for New Mexico State offense. Again, Thomas recording the kill to set up game point. The Aggies good on defense all game long. They forced the Roadrunners into a hitting error here after the rally. And good, the defense for New Mexico State, very solid. Runners rally themselves, but then the hitting error will end the set as New Mexico State wins 25-23. Second set, more of what I was talking about. The Aggies defense, they are just very good. And they kind of forced the Roadrunners to scramble around a lot and not a lot of great attack attempts, as New Mexico State will keep it rolling. The nice finish, and the Aggies build the lead 2-5 as once again Bradley Nash forcing the Runners into a hitting error. Bakersfield hit just 0-6-9 in the second set as New Mexico State took control to win the set 25-13. After the break, the Roadrunners in third set action, and you see Bakersfield here with the hitting error, and then we go to the third set after the break. Roadrunners trailing, and Runners finally got going. Kelsey Stoyer starts to get involved in the offense. Here's a nice set here and a kill for the Roadrunners. She had 9 kills in the match. Pretty low for her, though. Good moment, a momentum for CSUB. Good defense in this one as well. The dig from Fleming sets up another roll shot for Sawyer, and it's 6-2 Roadrunners. To 23-12 we go. New Mexico State servings. Martins once again to Sawyer. Runners, will they start to look on track? Martins ready to serve. Set point here for Bakersfield. The Aggies going to hit long, a good set, but they're going to hit long, and the Runners will win the set. So it's 2-1 heading into set number 4. Pretty much as close as it would get. New Mexico State pulls away in the fourth set. Just too good defensively. Too many weapons on this day as they take the early lead. 4-point match at 17-13. Another kill coming up here for Bradley Nash. Then, once again, Sasha Lee Thomas gets back into the action. And New Mexico State starts to roll. Gwen Murphy serving here. She had a team-high 15 kills, and this would end up setting up another point for New Mexico State. Again, a great defensive rally in the finish for the Aggies. And so setting up Game point for New Mexico State, and it's Natalie Castellanos completing the victory with the kills as New Mexico State right here is going to win it 4-1 over the Roadrunners at the Icardo Center. So a split for the Runners on the weekend. They lose to New Mexico State 4-1, and despite a close first set, they end up down 2-0 before the lone set win. Aditza Urias game-high 19 kills in the loss. They did beat UTRGV 3-0, 15 kills for Kelsey Sawyer, 14 for Sydney Haynes. Runners hit 380 in that match, including 516 in the second set. They were on fire in that one, as Bakersfield right now is a conference week schedule a couple weeks into it. Runners find themselves right in the middle of the pack once again. New Mexico State, Utah Valley, Seattle, UMKC, and the Runners are tied. Bakersfield sees UMKC this weekend. Matter of fact, taking a look at the upcoming games, Runners head the Midwest swing. They'll go to Chicago State on Thursday at 7, and they'll be at Kansas City on Saturday at 2 p.m. So there we go. Woo! How about that segment, huh? We are finished with it. We're going to take a break. When we return, we're going to speak with Dajy Vines and Alyssa Shannon as we'll talk CSUB women's basketball, all sorts of stuff with the team, and new rules in women's basketball. We'll get to that when we return. This is Roadrunner Rundown. Join the CSUB Alumni Association for the annual Party in the Park, Friday, October 23rd at Alumni Park on campus at CSUB. Tickets are $40 in advance or $50 at the door, or you can take advantage of new VIP tickets, which includes a special 5:30 p.m. admission time and exclusive VIP area for just $60. Make connections with CSUB alumni while enjoying wine, craft beer, along with great food pairings at this marquee event. Buy tickets online and save. Visit csub.edu/partyinthepark, and we'll see you October 23rd.
Introducing a new way to get the news. The Bakersfield Californian e-edition. It's not a website. It's the actual Bakersfield Californian right on your tablet computer, laptop, even your smartphone. All the news, features, pictures, and ads you're used to right at your fingertips. Now you can get the Californian on your schedule, anytime, anywhere, anyplace. Get your new Bakersfield Californian e-edition today. Visit eedition.bakersfield.com.
In a fertile valley, a growing university with record enrollment and graduates serving the needs of a thriving community, a tradition of athletic excellence. Now a part of the Western Athletic Conference. CSU Bakersfield.
The Bakersfield Californian is a great read on the iPad. But did you know that the Bakersfield Californian is available on your Kindle Fire? Or how about Google's Nexus 7? The Nook? You bet. You can also read a full replica of the newspaper on your Android-powered smartphone, on Apple's iPhone, or on your laptop. We have a solution for any device. E-Edition is free for subscribers, or just $7.99 a month. The Bakersfield Californian. We're everywhere and anytime. Subscribe today. Bakersfield.com.
The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund creates educational opportunities for over 300 student-athletes at CSUB. By becoming a member and donating to the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund, you're not only helping the Roadrunners fund the scholarship needs of our teams, you're investing in the future. The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund isn't just developing student-athletes. We're developing tomorrow's leaders from lessons learned during competition. For more information, log on to gorunners.com/donate and become a member of the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund.
Roadrunners basketball 2015-16 season tickets are on sale now. Don't miss your chance to see top-notch NCAA basketball right here on the blue court in Bakersfield. Men's basketball season tickets start as low as $112 for 16 games, or you can buy combination season tickets for every men's and women's home game this season. For all the new season ticket options for this season, visit GoRunners.com and find the ticket that's right for you. CSUB basketball season tickets available now. To order or for more information, call 654-BLUE.
Welcome back to Roadrunner Rundown. Still to come on the program, Jamie Carey-Morrell from CSUB Men's Soccer will be joining us. And also Meghan Thomason, our director of golf, will be chatting about an upcoming fundraiser for the golf program. We got that happening on the show today. And now joining us in studio, we have, a couple seniors. We have directly to my left, Alyssa Shannon, a senior point guard for the Roadrunners. And I should introduce our next guest as Dr. Dajy Vines, because she's been here for now 6 years. But because of injury, for good reason, she is now going to be entering her sixth senior. We call it, like, we have, like, redshirt senior. Like, you're listed as sixth senior on the roster. You know that, right?
Yes, I just seen
it
yesterday.
So, yeah, well, I'm glad you're back. I'm glad you're healthy again. And, ladies, welcome to the program. How you been?
Good.
Good.
So make sure you're talking to Mark, by the way. Get right on. There you go. So far practice, I mean, I know you guys started last week. So how's everything been so far?
Yeah, we're on our sixth practice, I think.
Day six.
Day six. And it's looking good. A lot of competitiveness. And the girls are looking good. New girls don't really know some of the plays,
right,
or whatever, but they're catching on really fast.
You guys have a very athletic team. I mean, just being around you during your photo day and surrounded, I'm like looking up at the entire team except Alyssa. and I'm looking and I'm going, this is a pretty athletic. I mean, you guys have a really solid looking basketball team now.
Yeah, we have a lot of height this year.
Yeah.
A lot.
What are your thoughts as a guard? I mean, you've got obviously a lot of post options this year, Alyssa. I mean, what do you think about some of the additional pieces of this team?
Yeah, I think Coach did a good job in recruiting. We have a lot of girls with, like you said, they're very athletic, so it's going to be fun just to get in there offensively and defensively because, you know, we're a defense-oriented team too, so it's going to be fun to see people playing on the ball and off the ball and getting a lot of steals.
There's new faces, but there is some core pieces to the roster. You know, you guys included that have been around for a few years. So how's that sort of gelling together, the experience that you guys have and then the new players as well?
I think they're actually fitting in really well. Summer helped a lot. We got to know each other. We got to see how each other plays on the floor, how everyone acts off the floor. And it's just like we have really good chemistry. Like our team's close. So I think coming into season, it's going to be good.
And that's what I've noticed, like, about as far as the team chemistry goes and being close. I mean, when the team shows up to an event, to someone else's game, it's like the entire team. It's not there's one or two players from the women's basketball team. It's the entire team for the most part. I mean, that's got to be good this point of the year to have that kind of chemistry.
Yeah, I think our team is really family-oriented. So when we do things, we like to do it together and as a group as opposed to, you know, individuals. So, and I think that plays a big role when we get on the floor, because it helps with our team chemistry and knowing that, you know, you're pretty close with the girl that you're pretty much going to battle with. Mm-hmm. So it helps on and off the floor.
How much did Costa Rica help? You guys got a chance to go play a little bit and see how one another plays on the court in a few exhibitions. How'd that help?
It helped out a lot. It gave us an opportunity to practice over the summertime, so we got a little head start. So we were able to go over our plays and get the freshmen involved and the transfers and get them able to kind of see what CSUB basketball is about, and everyone was able to get in tune earlier than they would have, especially since we're on the quarter system. We would have had to start a little bit later.
Sure.
So I think it's been really great to really see how each player can add to what we already had.
You guys are getting close to your games start in less than a month. The squad's been close the last couple of years too. You've been in the WNIT, but you've been close to the NCAA tournament twice. I mean, how does it feel going into this year? I mean, are you even hungrier for that opportunity?
I am, only because the way I went out last year, torn ACL, fourth time. I'm ready to come back and help out the team. And I think we're going to actually win the WAC championship this year and get to go to the NCAA tournament.
Yeah, and you guys you personally were on fire last year when you got hurt. I mean, I think you're the first player in the history of the WAC to get WAC Player of the Week the same week you actually went down injured for the rest of the season. I mean, you were on such a pace. Was it frustrating, or are you now just kind of over that part and focused on the next year?
At first it was frustrating, and I honestly didn't know what I wanted to do and if I wanted to continue playing because I was just tired of the injuries. But I just love the game, so I wasn't going to let another injury prevent me from playing the season.
Yeah, and how much do the coaches like trust you a little bit? I mean, since you started here, I mean, as 10-11 as a redshirt, now that you've been around the program for so long, do the coaches sort of, I mean, they look to you a little bit for guidance as well with the players since you've been around for such a long time?
Yeah, they expect me to make sure the girls are on top of everything, not even just basketball, just like school, make sure they're getting to study hall on time, make sure if we are all hanging out, everybody's hanging out together, just basically nobody gets left behind.
Nice.
And McCall, we have a really good relationship. he's the one that recruited me coming in for my freshman year. And I just been with him since he started his head coach position. And he just trusts me a little more.
Nice. No, it's a great chemistry makeup. I like the mixture that we have of returning players and then what we'll have coming in as well. Now, a big change this year in women's basketball. There's always rules changes, but usually they're subtle. But they've pretty much changed the women's game entirely this year. And they really made it more of a WNBA model. So what you see on TV watching the WNBA is what you're going to see in women's college basketball. And we've got some of the new rule changes. We made a little slide to help people follow along because there's so many things. All right, here's the biggest key. Each game, instead of two 20-minute halves like it used to be, like the men's game is, women's game is going to be four 10-minute periods. And on top of that, instead of going to the bonus and double bonus, it's going to be automatically a double bonus after each common foul, following the fifth foul after each period. Those are two pretty big changes. I mean, how does that change the game in your mind, Alyssa?
Well, offensively, switching from the 20-minute halves to the 10-minute quarters, I feel like that's going to speed up the game, which is a good thing for us. And for the free throws, the double bonus being at five fouls, that's really going to force players to really focus on not touching, because they've been trying to really emphasize not touching and not fouling.
Yeah,
so
one touch and that's it.
Right. So the double bonus have five fouls. That's going to be crucial. So.
And does it also make you guys say, I got to work on my free throws a little bit more?
Yeah.
Coach is very big on free throws. Mm-hmm. He's always like, free throws wins games, layups wins games. Mm-hmm. But he's really big on free throws. He always wants us to shoot 80% or better from the free throw line as a team.
And it might be huge this year. If you're looking at a lot of teams that might foul, you're looking at two shots, potentially 2 points per foul after the fifth.
Yeah.
So that could be crucial. The timeouts were changed a little bit. I mean, it doesn't affect the players too much, but 3 30-second timeouts, 2 60-second timeouts in non-media games. Most games are media now, so it'll be 3 30s and one full timeout during electronic media games. The 10-second backcourt clock doesn't restart anymore if the defense knocks the ball out of bounds or ties the ball up and the possession stays with the offense. It used to reset.
Yeah.
So now, I mean, point guard people like yourself, Alyssa, I mean, now you're not going to have the luxury of the 10-second clock restarting, so you got to get that ball across the court, don't you?
Mm-hmm. Very quickly.
With her speed, she's capable of it.
Thanks, Dajy.
Yeah, well, it's a mixture. It's kind of the rules are. It'll be interesting to see. I think the 10-minute periods and they kind of cut back on the media timeouts as well will speed things up. I'm interested to see what the two free throws after five fouls in each period will do. If that will slow the game down more or we'll pick it up. I don't know. I think that's going to be a question. I think it depends on the quality of competition. If you're playing a team that struggles defensively, reaches in a lot, grabs a lot, you're going to see probably a slower game. But they are trying to make it more consistent with the WNBA model. So that would be – and we're going to do a few – I'm going to need some help. I think we're going to do some like – fan sort of public service announcement videos that shows them what the new rules are, but like I'm gonna try to help act some of those rules out. So I'm gonna need your guys' help. All right. Since like I said, you're a couple of my favorites. Sure. Don't tell anybody. But we'll work on those. I think it'll be great. But there's a lot of new rule changes for women's basketball, and stay tuned on that. And I think people watching the game the first time might say, "What's going on?" Reminder: you can get a chance to take a look at the team on October 22nd, the blue and gold scrimmage at the Icardo Center at 6 p.m. at the Intersquad scrimmage, and other great festivities as well. Alyssa Shannon, Dajy Vines, thanks so much for joining us, ladies, and we'll be catching up with you as the season gets close here in, gosh, less than a month. So good luck.
Thank you.
All right. We'll be right back, folks. When we return, Jamie Carey-Morrell will join us. We'll talk CSUB men's soccer. They are on the road on Friday, at home on Sunday. We'll be back. This is Roadrunner Rundown. Join the CSUB Alumni Association for the annual Party in the Park, Friday, October 23rd at Alumni Park on campus at CSUB. Tickets are $40 in advance or $50 at the door, or you can take advantage of new VIP tickets, which includes a special 5:30 p.m. admission time and exclusive VIP area for just $60. Make connections with CSUB alumni while enjoying wine, craft beer, along with great food pairings at this marquee event. Buy tickets online and save. Visit csub.edu/partyinthepark, and we'll see you October 23rd.
Introducing a new way to get the news. the Bakersfield Californian e-edition. It's not a website. It's the actual Bakersfield Californian right on your laptop, tablet computer, even your smartphone. All the news, features, pictures, and ads you're used to right at your fingertips. Now you can get the Californian on your schedule, anytime, anywhere, any place. Get your new Bakersfield Californian e-edition today. Visit eedition.bakersfield.com.
In a fertile valley, a growing university with record enrollment and graduates serving the needs of a thriving community, a tradition of athletic excellence. Now a part of the Western Athletic Conference. CSU Bakersfield.
The Bakersfield Californian is a great read on the iPad, but did you know that the Bakersfield Californian is available on your Kindle Fire? Or how about Google's Nexus 7? The Nook? You bet. You can also read a full replica of the newspaper on your Android-powered smartphone, on Apple's iPhone, or on your laptop. We have a solution for any device. E-Edition is free for subscribers, or just $7.99 a month. The Bakersfield Californian. We're everywhere and anytime. Subscribe today. Bakersfield.com.
Roadrunners Basketball 2015-16 season tickets are on sale now. Don't miss your chance to see top-notch NCAA basketball right here on the blue court in Bakersfield. Men's basketball season tickets start as low as $112 for 16 games, or you can buy combination season tickets for every men's and women's home game this season. For all the new season ticket options for this season, visit GoRunners.com and find the ticket that's right for you. CSU Basketball season tickets available now. To order or for more information, call 654-BLUE.
The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund creates educational opportunities for over 300 student-athletes at CSUB. By becoming a member and donating to the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund, you're not only helping the Roadrunners fund the scholarship needs of our teams, you're investing in the future. The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund isn't just developing student-athletes. We're developing tomorrow's leaders from lessons learned during competition. For more information, log on to GoRunners.com/donate and become a member of the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund.
Welcome back to Roadrunner Rundown, and my thanks to Dajy Vines and Alyssa Shannon for joining us on the program. CSUB Women's Basketball expected to have a solid season in 2015-16. Again, the Blue-Gold Scrimmage, checking them out, and the men's team, October 22nd. That's next Thursday at the Icardo Center starting at 6, and you see the runners' teams and more information on a couple other preseason events coming up as well shortly on GoRunners.com. CSUB Men's Soccer, a decent weekend last weekend, pick up some important points in the conference. As beat Grand Canyon and tied with defending champion UNLV. I want to welcome to the program now. He is a sophomore for the Roadrunners, Jamie Carey-Morrell. Jamie, good to see you, man. How you been?
Very good, thank you. How have you been?
I'm great, and congrats on a you got a point on Friday night. That we had the goal earlier. Nice send to Mario. The nice bender over there. Obviously, he's kind of guy usually plays in the back, but you sort of try to sneak him up in those situations.
Yeah, we've been working on it in training, and. It paid off, so it was a good thing to happen.
Yeah, I think he headed it right into the ground, and it bounced over the keeper, and it was perfect. It worked out well. That was a big win. I mean, Grand Canyon came in a pretty good team, and to be able to beat them at home 2-1 was a good start to a pretty busy weekend.
Yeah, it was a brilliant start, and to beat a team that won't make the WAC tournament was very important for us.
Yeah.
To gain 3 points and get to the top of that table, hopefully, was a good start, and it made a good start for the weekend kind of thing. So.
And what was it like? I mean, we had 1,700 people that were there on Friday night, and I don't think they shut up the entire first half. I mean, they were chanting, and I mean, you're a guy from you're from England. You know about what real soccer sounds like. Yeah. That kind of probably sounded fairly similar, right?
Yeah, it was a great experience, and our coach tells us that. You should live for these moments, and to play in front of a great crowd and the athletes, it was a great thing to do, and to win as well, it makes it even better.
Yeah, so. It was a great finish, and you guys had the got the victory. And then on Sunday, just kind of a dogfight with UNLV. I mean, Such a talented team. They're very quick, and you guys are as well. So pretty evenly matched in that one. I guess a 1-1 draw is what we expected. You had to go to PKs in the WAC tournament to decide a winner. So, when looking at the UNLV team, you guys match up pretty well with them.
Yeah, it's always a close match with them, and I see them as a rival team, and we drew with him last in the WAC tournament, and so it was a hard game, hard fought game, and you saw the boys' effort. It was brilliant, and it was great team to play in, and it was a great game to play in. It was a well fought point. Yeah,
and you as a guy who's back on defense quite a bit, and then sometimes up in the mid, how tough are they to defend? I mean, they have some strikers, so how tough are they to defend?
They have a very good side, and when they counter attack and when they attack, they attack with pace, and that's the worst of the defender when someone's coming with pace. And but we defended very well, and we've defended very well the whole weekend, and it's a great positive, and it's going into a good side. So, and a good time in the conference. So,
And I know something that with the defense and the goaltending, something that Richie's really been preaching is communication. And you being a sophomore, and you got Zimmerman back there with you as well. He's a freshman. Are you guys all in Mario as well? Are you guys all kind of getting on the same page now, communicating more back on defense?
Yeah, well, as a defender, the worst thing to do is concede the goal. You feel like you let the team down, and it is our responsibility to keep the ball out of the net. And we've been narrowing the goals down, like to one goal kind of thing, but it's always good to keep a clean sheet, a shutout.
Yeah.
We're getting on very well, and it brings like a good connection with the back four.
Yeah, and I would say the goal that you guys gave up to Grand Canyon probably wasn't the defense's fault. That was a pretty good cross.
It was a good well-worked goal.
That was a big-time finish. You got to give them a little bit of credit on that one. Yeah. I wouldn't put that on the defense at all.
Yeah.
They played it nicely. So you guys now with a really interesting stretch. You're going to be on the road. Now, Seattle and Utah Valley entering last week were both nationally ranked.
Yeah.
Seattle had a setback, so they're probably going to be out of the top. I haven't seen the polls yet. But Utah Valley will be in the top 25. Yeah. So you're going to see Seattle on Friday in Seattle. You guys have had some success up there. You beat Seattle last time in penalty kicks in the WAC tournament up there. You're looking forward to that that rematch.
Yeah, I always look forward to the hardest games of the season, and well, every game's hard, but these two, like you said, they're national ranked, and it'll be good to beat both of them. We're looking forward to it as a team, and we're unbeaten and free, which is good, and it's given us confidence, and we feel that we can achieve both wins. So.
And you're probably looking forward to going to play in Seattle, where it's probably been a little bit cooler than home matches.
It reminds me of my hometown, so it's nice to play. And
And of course, last week we have the Heat, and we bring in two desert teams.
Yeah.
We have Grand Canyon out of Phoenix and UNLV. Yeah. They're like, this is like home. It wasn't much of a home field advantage last week, but you'll go to Seattle, where it's going to be a little cooler on Friday. And then an interesting deal, you'll travel back. And then Utah Valley will travel from their home to Bakersfield as well.
Yeah.
You guys might even be on the same flight. I don't know. It might even work out that way.
Yeah.
And then you'll play Utah Valley on Sunday at 1 o'clock back in Bakersfield. So kind of an interesting setup for the weekend. But both teams having to travel on Saturday, it's going to be kind of interesting.
Yeah, we'll recover well from the Friday game. Hopefully with a win, and then we go again on Sunday, and we try and get that win.
It didn't seem like, and that's something that we brought up with Richie a lot, and. A lot of sports play the Thursday, Saturday, or in your guys' case, Friday, Sunday conference. I mean, obviously soccer is so physically demanding, and especially if you play extra time on Friday or anything, but you only have that one day to recover, and you got to play again. Seemed like on Sunday you guys recovered pretty well, and you were right there.
Yeah.
Are you feeling like it's getting a little bit easier to recover, or does it get harder as the season wears on because you guys are more and more beat up?
Well, back home we play one game a week. So that was a big transition for me to play two games in a weekend. But as a team, we look after ourselves, and we make that our main priority. And we came out strong on Sunday, and I thought our game plan suited the way that we wanted to play. We held back, and we conserved our energy. And then when we was ready to go, we went and scored. And unlucky with the goal to concede, but like you said, recovery is so important for us. And That's the big thing, and that's how you win these big games on the Sunday.
And it seemed like you had the energy, because on Sunday's match, and you bring up an interesting point, there were times when you could tell Richie said, okay, let's go, and all of a sudden you guys were pressing and attacking, and you had some teeth, and you had some legs underneath you. So obviously that's a good sign that the recovery is going well.
Yeah, so we work on that in practice, how to attack basically and go for them at a good point when we think we can win the ball. But most of the time we sit back and we conserve our energy, ready to pounce on them and win the ball and then hopefully create chances through that.
Nice. Jamie Carey-Morrell joining us here on Roadrunner Rundown. Sophomore out of, now it's Stevenage, England?
Yeah.
Correct, all right.
Yeah.
I want to get it right. Yeah. I always screw that up for some reason. what brought you to Bakersfield? I mean, you know, international player. What made you want to come to CSUB?
So it didn't work out professionally back home. I wasn't offered my professional contract, but I already had this in my mind. Back home, there's a setup where they give the advice to you to come out here. And
right.
I had that background, and Richie got in contact with me because I went out to America two Christmases ago, and I played in a tournament for my club, and Richie spotted me, and he wanted to recruit me. So I had good contacts with him, and then it just happened. I was so happy when it happened.
Do you like the setup? I mean, I hear a lot of international players that love the setup, the ability to go to school and play,
because
you don't get that opportunity back at home.
No, the opportunity out here is so much bigger, and I love it. It's the best move I've made in my life, and I don't regret my decision once. To study and to play soccer is perfect because you have two backgrounds, and you have two roots to go down.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
What's nice? Have you decided on the major yet?
I actually decided this morning.
Okay.
I had a meeting with my business.
This is breaking news right now, by the way, because in his bio it says Jamie was undecided on a major. Okay, let the folks know what you're majoring now, since it's breaking news this morning.
Okay, so I'm majoring in business administration now.
All right.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
All right. Business administration.
Yeah.
I'm going to update your bio right now. Business admin major.
Yeah.
I like it. All right.
Yeah.
Any ideas what after soccer you might want to do with something like that?
My goal and my dream has always been a professional soccer player, and I'm going to carry on until I have to call it a day. But with academics and business, I have a good contact back home who can help me and assist me. That's my choice for that business and that major kind of thing. So I have two strong things to go back to, and I'm looking forward to
it. Well, if it doesn't work out as a player, you can run a club.
Yeah,
with a business administration degree.
Exactly.
Your mom and grandfather had a chance to come out and visit this past weekend. And got a chance to meet them because they like to watch the matches over. They get up at 4 o'clock in the morning and watch you guys play.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
I love it, and I love them just as much as I love soccer. They love it just as much as they love me too.
Obviously Friday night was a great atmosphere, so they probably loved the love what was happening this past weekend.
They said it was a great experience, and they both said that they go away from this comfortable and they know that I'm living happily, and they're excited for me, and they're excited for my future. So
yeah, your mom said take care of him for me.
Yeah. So I think she said that to everyone.
Well, we're taking care of him, we promise.
Yeah.
You guys are getting a tough weekend coming up, and then a few more home matches, and then on the road in the WAC tournament, so still a lot of play to go in conference, and of course the conference tournament in Kansas City. What are kind of the goals right now for the team as you sort of start to bear down on the home stretch?
We're always going for that first place. And if not, we're trying to finish in the top six, because our goal is to finish at the WAC tournament and better last year. We want to win it, and we want to go to nationals, because that's everyone's goal, and that's what everyone wants to do, basically.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Awesome. Well, you guys are definitely getting better as the weeks go on. And big match this week, Friday night against Seattle. They're in second place right now. That'll be in Seattle. And then Sunday, 1 o'clock against first place Utah Valley. And you can also watch that on the WAC Digital Network. Jamie, thanks for joining us, man. Congratulations on the major.
Yeah.
Well done. And we'll be keeping up with you as the season continues.
Brilliant. Thank you very much.
All right. Jamie Carey-Morrell here on Roadrunner Rundown. When we come back, Meghan Thomason, our director of golf, will join us. They got a big fundraiser coming up. We'll tell you all about it. This is Roadrunner Rundown. Join the CSUB Alumni Association for the annual Party in the Park, Friday, October 23rd at Alumni Park on campus at CSUB. Tickets are $40 in advance or $50 at the door, or you can take advantage of new VIP tickets, which includes a special 5:30 p.m. admission time and exclusive VIP area for just $60. Make connections with CSUB alumni while enjoying wine, craft beer, along with great food pairings at this marquee event. Buy tickets online and save. Visit CSUB.edu/partyinthepark, and we'll see you October 23rd.
Introducing a new way to get the news. The Bakersfield Californian e-edition. It's not a website. It's the actual Bakersfield Californian right on your tablet computer, laptop, even your smartphone. All the news, features, pictures, and ads you're used to right at your fingertips. Now you can get the Californian on your schedule, anytime, anywhere, any place. Get your new Bakersfield Californian e-edition today. Visit eedition.bakersfield.com.
The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund creates educational opportunities for over 300 student-athletes at CSUB. By becoming a member and donating to the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund, you're not only helping the Roadrunners fund the scholarship needs of our teams, you're investing in the future. The Roadrunner Scholarship Fund isn't just developing student-athletes. We're developing tomorrow's leaders from lessons learned during competition. For more information, log on to gorunners.com/donate and become a member of the Roadrunner Scholarship Fund.
The Bakersfield Californian is a great read on the iPad, but did you know that the Bakersfield Californian is available on your Kindle Fire? Or how about Google's Nexus 7? The Nook? You bet. You can also read a full replica of the newspaper on your Android-powered smartphone, on Apple's iPhone, or on your laptop. We have a solution for any device. E-Edition is free for subscribers, or just $7.99 a month. The Bakersfield Californian. We're everywhere and anytime. Subscribe today. Bakersfield.com.
In a fertile valley, a growing university with record enrollment and graduates serving the needs of a thriving community, a tradition of athletic excellence. Now a part of the Western Athletic Conference. CSU Bakersfield.
Roadrunners Basketball 2015-16 season tickets are on sale now. Don't miss your chance to see top-notch NCAA basketball right here on the blue court in Bakersfield. Men's basketball season tickets start as low as $112 for 16 games, or you can buy combination season tickets for every men's and women's home game this season. For all the new season ticket options for this season, visit GoRunners.com and find the ticket that's right for you. CSU Basketball season tickets available now. To order or for more information, call 654-BLUE.
Welcome back to Roadrunner Rundown. My thanks to Jamie Carey-Morrell for joining us in the last segment. Dajy Vines and Alyssa Shannon back in the first segment. You can get the show anytime, by the way, online at GoRunners.com if you missed any portion of the program. And next week on the show, we're going to have some reaction from WAC Media Day, a basketball preview. We'll have that coming up. That's going on this week, as a matter of fact. Preseason polls will be out on Wednesday, so we'll be talking about that a little bit on next week's program, hearing from some of the coaches as well as we get ready for the upcoming basketball season. Don't forget, next Thursday will be the Blue Gold scrimmage at the Icardo Center with men's and women's basketball. I want to welcome to the program now. She is our director of golf and also head coach of the CSUB women's golf program. And, well, just all-around golf expert Meghan Thomason joining us on the program. Good to see you. How you been?
Been busy. Thanks for having me on. I appreciate the opportunity to come on.
Yeah, no worries. Anytime. I know fall is kind of a weird time for the team. You practice a little bit. You've got a few competitions. The meat of your schedule is in the spring.
It is.
But you get a chance to play a little bit in the fall.
We do. We do. We finished up the Wyoming University Invitational in Palm Desert, 55 shots better than last year, so that's a great start.
Nice.
The men played really, really well in Utah. So, yeah, the ball's rolling for us. You know, been out practicing for about a month and a half now, and both sides are looking really great.
Yeah, you have all of your golf team coming back on the women's side.
Mm-hmm.
And again, you brought up the 55 strokes improvement from a year ago, which is great. What's been the difference with that team? Is it just practice getting better, focus, that kind of stuff?
It's maturity. And it's been, you know, a year of really hard work.
Yeah.
These kids, you know, when they came in last year, you know, I set the bar really high and they met it last year, exceeded it really last year. And it's just a matter of kind of knowing the program, knowing my expectations, knowing what to expect when we go to golf tournaments now, kind of what the course conditions are going to be like, the competition. So yeah, it's just, you know, really a year of competition under any college athlete's belt is going to be, you know, a big advantage.
Nice, nice. What's really the strength, I guess, of this team? I know it's a little different with golf because it's such an individual sport, but what's kind of the strength of this squad this year?
You know, overall, our short game, putting and chipping, has improved like tremendously. like, I can't even tell you the statistics. Like, they're just unbelievable. They grind it out really, really hard in practice on the greens. So that's something that's really shown in our scores. Yeah. And then, you know, the ball striking's coming around. We've been working really hard on that for about the last 2 weeks.
I've been out on the course a couple times with the team just to, like, shoot some of my silly segments. And it amazes me. I mean, you say the ball striking's coming around. They're still hammering the ball off the tee. And, like, I can't even – and they make it look so easy.
They
like
do. Yeah.
Chandler Bowman, for example, just has, like, the best swing that I've ever seen. It just makes it look easy, and she's putting it out two and change.
She's awesome. She just – yeah, she just kind of steps up there, doesn't overthink it, and just, like, lets it rip off the tee.
Yeah.
She just – you know, she gets after it.
I think it's time for another golf lesson. I needed a lesson from them because the last one didn't really work. But 55 strokes is pretty impressive on that improvement, and another tournament coming up, as you mentioned. Now, a big fundraiser coming up. Golf, one of the programs that's constantly fundraising.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to have a tell the folks about what's happening on November 6th.
November 6th, we're hosting a dinner and auction fundraiser at Majid and Willa Mojibi's house. Mr. and Mrs. Mojibi are a huge supporter of the golf program, and they were generous enough to offer their home up for this fundraiser. It's going to be dinner. It's going to be an open bar with beer and wine. Little auction, a chance to meet myself and Coach Bunker and our players as well. We're really proud of the young men and women on the golf teams, both on and on the golf course. They're just outstanding individuals, and they're going to be really outstanding members of the community here in Bakersfield once they graduate. So just an overall, you know, chance to come out and support CSUB Golf.
Yeah, $50 donation per person. The dinner, drinks, auction, proceeds going to the CSUB men's and women's golf teams. Do you have some of the auction stuff out? You have any idea what's going to...
Yeah, we have a big fishing trip, a two-day fishing trip for six people.
Nice.
Out of Santa Cruz. We have some men's NCAA Final Four tickets that
nice.
Are up for grabs. Obviously, rounds of golf, golf clubs,
right.
Lessons. You know, it's going to be a big thing for golf enthusiasts, that's
cool.
for sure.
No, and that's a great deal as well. If people want to go out and just meet the team. And obviously, that's the cool part with, I think you probably realize it as a coach, especially when you're fundraising. Like, if you just get, when you get the student-athletes involved, if you get them with people, like, it's hard for people to not say no, but it's hard for people not to want to be supportive because you guys have some pretty great kids on the team.
Absolutely. You spend 5 minutes with either, you know, the men or the women on the golf teams, and you'll just, you know, you'll love them.
Yeah.
You'll want to, you know, look out for their scores on Go Runners, follow us on Golf Stat, all that good stuff.
Yeah.
So they're really great kids.
Awesome. And you've been working now the second year. Meghan Bunker now working with you as the men's coach.
Mm-hmm.
We just refer to you as the Meghans.
Yes.
But how's that relationship gone? You guys seem to be both turning both programs around.
It's going really well. We work well together. You know, support on both sides. I'm supportive of her. She's supportive of me. And it's really great to have some continuity for our players.
Mm-hmm.
You know, really coaches that are there for them 100% no matter what, whether it's, you know, wanting to chat in the office about school or golf or whatever. You know, I think we've both established really good relationships with our players, and that's the most important thing. That's what we're here for.
Awesome. And what's been the, you know, your couple seasons, what's been, you know, your favorite part about being at CSUB, being with the athletics department, coaching this team?
The athletics department's just awesome. Everybody is so supportive of one another. And getting to meet, you know, the greater, you know, community of Bakersfield as a whole and become more of a part of that has been really something that I've enjoyed.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, just right now trying to drum up the support that, you know, we feel in athletics throughout the community.
Yeah. Awesome. And again, that you get a chance to show that support Friday, November 6th at 6 p.m. If you go to our website, GoRunners.com, you can get all the information on that. Go to the golf page, the information on how to register, all that stuff. You can contact Meghan. All of her contact information is on the
mm-hmm.
website, correct? And again, the RSVP card is there too. And it should be a great night. I mean, $50. And again, you get a chance to hang out with the team and have dinner and just sort of see what CSUB Golf is all about. Because it really is about the student athletes. When you get a chance to be around them, that's
really
definitely
is.
A huge plus. What, like we said, it's kind of a weird time of the season. You play a little bit, then you're off a little
mm-hmm.
bit. So what do you try to accomplish in the fall as you prepare for the spring where your championships are held?
Fall is just kind of knocking the rust off. Getting out in competition a little bit more. All of our players played summer golf, but, you know, golf in college in the fall is just a little bit different
yeah.
with the team aspect. And then, you know, like I said, kind of getting the program established for our players. They've been hitting it really, really hard in the gym. And then once we come back after Christmas break, that's when, you know, it's time to buckle down. And
mm-hmm.
it's just, you know, golf all the time, really. All the way, you know, January all the way through your early May.
So. Yeah. All right. Well, we're in a climate that supports it, so that's good. That's mm-hmm. a good spot.
Big recruiting tool.
Yeah, exactly. and great. And it seems like you guys have great partnerships with almost every course in the community to give you guys an opportunity to play.
We do. It's huge. We couldn't do what we do or be as successful as we have been without their support. No
nice.
Doubt.
Awesome. I know that's a huge recruiting tool as well. When people yeah. say, yeah, and come to this course and play, and this is they want to support us. So that's great. Mm-hmm. All right, Meghan, thanks so much for joining us again. GoRunners.com, folks can check out. Go to the golf page. All the information on the dinner at the Mojibi's house. It's going to be on November 6th. All right. Thanks so much, Meghan. We'll see you again as we get closer to the start of the season.
Thanks again for having me.
All right. Roadrunner Golf and, of course, a fundraiser Friday, November 6th. And you can get all information on that online at GoRunners.com. You can get the rest of the program and see the archive editions of this show as well on GoRunners.com. Just one home event this weekend. It'll be Sunday. The Roadrunner men's soccer team after that Friday night game at Seattle will be back at the main soccer field at 1 o'clock. So you'll get an opportunity to see them. Tickets are available. GoRunners.com/TIX. Or you can watch the game on the WAC Digital Network if you're unable to be there. And we'll be back on the program next week. A lot of stuff happening with WAC basketball. The preseason polls will be out and Media Day will be in the books. That's happening this week. We'll bring you some of the highlights from that in Las Vegas as we get ready for basketball season. Don't forget Blue Gold Scrimmage coming up on Thursday the 22nd. More on that on next week's program as well. Have a great rest of the day, folks. We'll catch you next time. This has been Roadrunner Rundown.